Hi everyone, this is Experience Javi, and I'm here to talk about Gyodi, which is the penultimate album by the Alan Parsons Project. It's an album that was inspired by, well, a travel Eric Wolfson made to Barcelona in Spain, my country. And there in Barcelona, he got to find some beautiful buildings and architectural structures that were owned by the architect called Antonio Gaudí. And then he decided to record an album inspired in this gentleman, in this Catalan gentleman that created La Sagrada Familia, Park Güell, and other beautiful buildings and parks and different structures that keep existing today. The gentleman had a Catalan origin, and his architecture is very much based in Mediterranean tendencies, which are very much creative and imaginative, more than Nordic architecture, which is more repetitive and rigid. Well, this album is not very well acclaimed by critics in general, but I consider it a very good album, and I will defend my opinion, my point of view. I don't consider it a masterpiece, but it's a very good pop rock album with a little bit of a pop edge and has a little bit of symphonic rock as well, especially in the first track, which is La Sagrada Familia. I need to say as well that this album was important for me because I was 14 when it came out, and a friend in the city I was living in was showing me the Alan Parsons Project discography. And then when I was starting to know these albums, Gaudí appeared, this album appeared, and it was quite a very good finding for me. I quite liked the main song, La Sagrada Familia, which I consider the best track ever in the whole discography of the Alan Parsons Project. And when many people say that it's not a great album in the discography, and they prefer especially the first three or four albums, and they used to say that the Alan Parsons Project has a up-to-down kind of itinerary in their albums, but I don't agree with that, because obviously the first albums are very good, and I would as well highlight the chorus that give them a very elegant and archaic kind of sound. But some of their last albums are among the best for me, and in this case it's a very good album in a time when music was about to change in a big way. Anyway, La Sagrada Familia, the first song, well, it starts with a lot of sound effects and the voice of Alan Parsons introducing a little bit of the general aspects of Antonio Gaudí's career.
In recent times, there is no one who could approach at all to Antonio Gaudí. He started.
And then a very pop electric piano appears and song develops with John Miles, which is the main singer of the song, and is my favorite singer, is my favorite vocalist in the Alan Parsons Project. He sang beautiful songs like Casco Fomontilado, Siriotomy, Shadow of a Lonely Man, and other songs. And he's got quite a very raw style and a very emotional kind of singing with a high range as well of tone in his voice. And this song is perfect. I mean, nobody can say that the qualities of the first three albums or four albums are not present in this song, because you've got almost everything that characterizes the Alan Parsons Project music. You have the horns, you have the violins, you have the guitar, you have the choir, you have everything. And for all those years, our eyes and ears were filled with tears. It's a very epic song, and It speaks about a road, a spiritual road, in which there is always a long for a beautiful future. It's a very spiritual song, and I think the imagination of Eric Wilson was boosted by this over that Antonio Gaudí built, which I don't know if you know it, but it hasn't been finished yet, and it's probably going to take forever to finish it, because it's only in the probably first quarter or first fifth part of its realization, and they keep on building it, you know. But the song is amazing. It's a fantastic song. It's a very inspiring and filled with different emotions, because you have parts that are kind of like a ballad, other parts that are like a very epic kind of orchestral, full sounding symphonic song, you know, and everything in between. And then Ian Berson's solo is fantastic as well. It appears in the key moments of the song. And even the final part of the song is quite beautiful, because Eric Wolfson sings with this very soft and mellow voice, saying, "Until the next time."
Until the next time.
Like saying, "I'll come back to Barcelona to watch La Sagrada Familia very soon again," you know. It's a very complete song, almost 9 minutes of a song, and I think the standard of quality of this song is very high, very high. I don't think there is a song like that in the whole catalog of the Alan Parsons Project, no matter which album you can mention. And it's pompous, it's pretentious, but it's just perfect. I mean, it doesn't really go outside of what it intends to be, which is a very powerful and evoking song. And then, well, we appear into a song that may grow a little bit longer for you to like it, because it's sung by Lenny Sakatek. Lenny Sakatek's songs in the Alan Parsons Project are very particular. He's always very angry in his way of singing, and this is not an exception, because he sings about somebody that's been let down and says to his partner, "Too late, it's too late for you," and all that. The thing is, when you listen to the song a few times, the song is absolutely brilliant. It has an intro with a chorused guitar, and simply the singing of Lenny Sakatek is the best in the whole The Alan Parsons Project albums, you know. I think he's grown quite self-confident and more melodic in his voice than in his first songs, you know. And in this case, he sings in a high-pitched voice, but it's a very pop song, but it's perfect. All the elements fit together very well. You have synthesizers doing the accompaniment, and the guitar solo by Ian Berson is very high standard as well, very good. More angry and more industrial sounding as well. But this album is a complete search for beauty, and this song is one of the examples. You know, it's called Closer to Heaven, and it's kind of a heavenly poem that Eric Wolfson sings, inspired in Antonio Gaudí's longings for being quite a very good professional, and his spiritual longings as well. And the main important thing, in my opinion, of this song is a very beautiful percussion arrangement that sounds very tribal and very natural. It has a beautiful sound to it. And the singing of Eric Wolfson is mellower and stronger than in the rest of his songs in the former albums. In this case, you get him singing with a sound that is very well treated in sound-wise, and as well, he's got the perfect melody. It's a beautiful song. It has a very dreamy saxophone solo as well, followed by an Ian Berenson solo as well on the guitar. And the song is a very beautiful song, very dreamy, very, I would say, sentimental, and with a sense of innocence, and it gives it a nice close to this A side of the album, which is only three songs, because obviously La Sagrada Familia is a very long song. And then you get the other side of the album, B side, and we start with Standing on Higher Ground, which was a hit, one of the biggest hits in the Alan Parsons Project's career, and the song is sung by Geoff Bardale, and it speaks about knowing more and acquiring more knowledge about the world we're living in, and that making you be in a more dangerous position, you know? Like a song in the Alan Parsons solo career says, ignorance is bliss. So when you get to know more and more things, you get more compromised. And that's a very philosophical thought in this song. And there was a link in this song as well. But I don't speak. Not to close my eyes, pretending I'm asleep. The song is very well arranged, pop song, very, very pop. I mean, this album is very pop as well as Vulture Culture. They are probably the most pop the Alan Parsons Project albums. It's a very, very good song as well, with a nice two-guitar solo and very punchy and constant rhythm. That makes it a very suitable song for the radio. And actually, it sold a lot as a single. And then we have a song that's called Money Talks, and it's sung as well by John Miles as well as La Sagrada Familia. But in this case, I consider this song to be one of the weakest songs in the whole discography. The song is a bit failed. It starts with a nice guitar riff and all that, and it speaks about money, how money is like a green machine, it dominates everything. But I think the lyrics go nowhere, really. It tries to be philosophical about money and all that, but it's just a bit of a failed song. It tries to be the hard rock, edgy song of the album, but it fails completely, and the song is quite mediocre. The backing vocals sound a bit just, how can I put it, just a bit average, and it just doesn't really inspire you for much, you know. Then after that song, you get a very, very dreamy and beautiful song that's called Inside Looking Out. It's sung by Eric Wolfson again, and it carries on with that idea of this former song called Closer to Heaven, and it speaks about how much a dreamer Antonio Gaudí was, and how he longed for very beautiful and sublime things in his life. And you know, this song is a part of the trend of this last part of the Alan Parsons project, in which they were searching for beauty, for poetry. And I like that so much, because it's a beautiful feeling, you know, when you try to search for pure and beautiful things, even when it can sound so simple, you know.
Now is the hour and the moment.
Consider it to be a beautiful song as well, and then it takes you to Paseo de Gracia. Which is just a street in Barcelona, and the song is mainly an instrumental version of La Sagrada Familia with the same rhythm, but with a lead Spanish guitar on top of it, which matches beautifully with the music, and it gives it a sound of classical and beautiful Spanish edge, you know, to this finish of the album. Having said that, Catalans, northeast part of Spain, became really annoyed with this, because I don't know if you know about the political issues there, but they want to separate from Spain, and they have a different culture and all that. So when Alan Parsons and Eric Woolfson made this song and this album sounding quite Spanish, especially La Sagrada Familia and Paseo de Gracia, they felt really offended, because they wanted to be acknowledged as a very different culture from the Spanish one, you know. And this brought to a polemic that was quite notorious in this time, you know, at the end of the 80s. And they had to apologize and all that. But, well, it's quite silly, really, because they might as well have laughed about it, but they were so serious about it, but who cares anyway? It's just music, you know. Anyway, the album is brilliant. It's not a masterpiece, but it's a well-put album with nice pop numbers, a failed rock song, and an epic song that is just above everything you can listen to. I mean, a beautiful song. La Sagrada Familia is probably a little bit of a bizarre song because of a chorus song in Spanish. You know, you're not familiar with that. La Sagrada Familia. Or if you sing it in a Spanish accent, it would be La Sagrada Familia. But anyway, the song is amazing. John Miles is on the top of his league on this song, and it's a very well-arranged song and a very evoking song. So I'm going to give Antonio Gaudí, well, Gaudí, the album, an 8 out of 10. And, you know, after that, everything went wrong, because they split. There was the last album made for Diana. But, you know, some people say it's always the same, you know, it's always the same music, it's the same concepts, it's all about the same kind of style of music. Even Alan Parsons said in one time, I can't believe we carry on being successful with so much time doing the same thing. But anyway, I mean, if you listen to any, you're not going to expect to listen to punk music or rock music or listen to drums and electric guitar. You know, you're going to listen to a piano and a lot of beautiful female voices and all that. So the Alan Parsons Project is the Alan Parsons Project. You probably have other bands that have innovated quite a lot in their albums, and they've given a lot of surprises to the audiences. Probably not always those surprises were positive, but in this case, you know what you have. I mean, they are quite predictable, but it's always top-notch music. It's always high-quality music, which is what it's all about. I mean, quality is everything, and every single The Alan Parsons Project album, even the worst one, is above 7 out of 10. So that says everything about this band, one of the best bands ever. Thank you for listening, and I'll see you on the next video. I'm going upside down, I'm going backwards, so next one is gonna be Stereotomy, which I consider another very good album and a very underrated one, just like Gaudi is. Thank you very much for watching. Please subscribe and love you.